I am Devraj Goyal, Professor Educational Technology from CIET NCERT New Delhi, India. Today we will focus on research scenario of teacher education in India. It is under the course Perspectives, Issues and Research in Teacher Education. Let us delineate the objectives. After going through this module, the learners will be able to understand the research scenario in teacher education, list the issues related to research and development, work out the possible solutions of the identified issues, enunciate the criteria for assessment of teacher education institutions, and work out the research agenda. Introduction. Research and development go together. Research leads to development and development to research. Now we will focus on the research scenario of teacher education in India. The present module attempts to present the research scenario of teacher education cutting across various facets as follows. Classroom teaching effectiveness. S. Chawla, MDU 2005, conducted a study on interactional analysis of classroom behavior of effective and ineffective Hindi teachers. R. Parikh, Banasthali Vidyapit, 2005, conducted an analytical study of computer curriculum in teacher education program. S. Singh, MDU 2005, studied the effect of classroom questioning behavior training on teaching competence of student teachers and their self-concept. V. Upadhyay, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar University, 2005, conducted comparative study of the impact of the teacher's training on self-concept, attitude towards teaching, and values in self-financing and government-aided institutions. P. Mishra, KUK 2004, conducted a comparative study of classroom verbal behavior of student teachers and in-service science teachers of secondary schools. V. Singh, University of Lucknow 2004, studied the effect of BEd training program on teaching competence of pupil teachers. LKM Baburao, Andhra University 2003, conducted a study of diets, CTEs and IASEs with special reference to National Policy of Education, 1986. S.P. Shukla, Gujarat Vidyapeeth 2003, studied the effectiveness of video programs with discussion, without discussion and traditional methods on the achievement of student teachers in context of some variables. Padmini P. Rani Avinash Lingam Deemed University 2003, developed oral communication efficiency in English, BEd trainees. R. Chandra, Punjab University 2002, focused on sustainable changes relevant to community and school needs in curricular input and transactional modes of elementary teacher education. A study on the effect of the learning inputs provided in teacher education program on teaching efficiency of teachers was conducted by A. Goyal, Banasthali Vidyapeeth, 2002. V. Vora, KUK, 2002, proposed a prospective training model after identifying training needs of secondary school language teachers. K. Jayaramanna, Andhra University, 2001, conducted a study of teacher effectiveness in relation to work orientation and achievement of students at primary level. S. Devi, MDU, 2001, studied the effect of classroom questioning behavior training using games on teaching competence and pupils' achievement. J.K. Suhag, MDU 2001, has done interactional analysis of classroom behavior of effective and ineffective history teachers. M.S. Bhatt, Gujarat Vidyapeeth 2001, conducted a study on primary education trainees' perceptions of teaching. R. Balu, SNDT 2001, conducted a study of role performance of teacher educators in relation to their profile. M. Singh, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar University 2000, conducted a study on identification and comparison of language skills for Hindi and English teachers of secondary school level. D.T. Reddy, University of Mysore 2000, conducted a critical study of professional pleasure in relation to creativity and change proneness among secondary school teachers. S. Kher, DAVV 1999, conducted a case study on development of need-based program for pre-primary teacher education. A.K. Srivastava, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar University, 1999, conducted a comparative study of the effect of training on teaching attitude and self-concept of various types of trainees under DIET program. Baiju K. Nath, University of Calicut, 1998, developed self-instructional package for secondary school biology teachers for their in-service learning. H.B. Jani, Bhavnagar University, 1998, studied secondary education trainees' perceptions of teaching. Mamta, Shri Sahuji Maharaj University, 1998, explored factors of specific training needs of lady teachers in primary school. U. Sharma, MLS University, 1993, conducted a study on crystallization of professional values among the teachers of higher secondary schools in Rajasthan. A large number of educational instructional interventions have been reported to be effective. Now, predictors of teaching proficiency. G. Londe, Pune University, 2003, studied the teaching aptitude of students, teachers with reference to creativity and teaching competence. C. Shekhar, Bundelkhand University, 2002, conducted a study of the locus of control of pupil teachers admitted on weightage of Bundelkhand University in relation to their future teaching effectiveness. D. Bland, MDU, 1999, has done an investigation into the study habits, reading interests, attitude towards teaching, and their bearing upon the achievement of the pre-service teachers. N. Kumari, Punjab University, 1999, has conducted a study of entrance tests and measurement performance of BA trainees as related to psychological and socio-demographic variables. D. K. Diwan, MDU 1993, conducted a study of the predictors of academic achievement of student teachers in terms of aptitude, attitude, participation, and human values. All these studies have contributed to the knowledge base significantly, but there is a need to work out the admission criteria into various teacher education programs still systematically. Now, organizational climate and teaching. S. Awasthi, Bundelkhand University, 2002, conducted a study on teacher alienation, their morale and principals' leadership and institutional effectiveness in different intermediate colleges on the basis of organizational climate. A. Day, Bundelkhand University, 2000, studied the teachers' professional values, family relationship and anxiety in relation to organizational climate. R. M. Ghatel, SNDT, 1999, conducted a study of teacher performance and job satisfaction of teachers in relation to their maturity, locus of control, and organizational conflict. N. Singh, Jai Narayan University, 1999, conducted a study of senior secondary schools of Jodhpur Division in terms of organizational health and teachers' attitude towards teaching profession and adjustment. There is a need to develop healthy organizational climate for effective education. Now, innovations in teacher education. Teacher education has experienced micro-teaching, model teaching, and techno-pedagogy. The innovation of micro-teaching has been institutionalized across India. Model teaching appeared and disappeared at demonstration level, whereas techno-pedagogy is in its infancy. Personalized teacher education appeared in one form or the other, DABV Indore, Banasthali, Lucknow University. A large number of visitors visited these personalized teacher education programs, appreciated but non-institutionalized in their institutions. Participatory approaches to problem solving have been effectively demonstrated in classroom. Attempts have been made by the Intel Teach to the Future in integrating ICT in teacher education at pre-service and in-service levels. Intel has been organizing training programs to orient the pre-service and in-service teachers with sizable inputs. The Regional Institute of Education of the NCERT have been offering BA, BSc Ed, and MA, MSc Ed integrated programs of teacher education. Also, the RIEs have been offering two-year integrated B.Ed program. The Zakir Hussain Center of Education, Delhi University, has been offering four-year integrated program for primary teachers. A two-year PG diploma in educational technology proposed by one of the PG departments of teacher education in India has been approved. Also, a two-year integrated MED program has been approved by Integrated Teacher Education Programs for Higher Education, and e-teacher education programs have been formulated by some of the institutions. Number of innovations are evident in evaluation such as CBCS, electronic distribution of examination papers, on-demand testing, automated testing, double valuation, testing of affect attributes. Progressively, there is a shift to total internal evaluation based semester system. Teacher education is progressively integrating such practices in teacher education curricula. The question of formulating norms and standards arises when the institutions apply to institutionalize or replicate these innovations. Now we go on to ET and ICT in education. A sizable number of studies on effectiveness of CI developed through various computer languages employing either pre-experimental design or quasi-experimental design reveal significant mean score gain from pre-test to post-test. Studies on the effectiveness of CAI reveal favorable reactions of students and teachers towards the CAI. Prabhakar 1989, Himani 1990, Mahapatra 1991, and Adhikari 1992, DABB Indore. Khirwadkar 1999, Jyod 1999, Yadav 2000, Goyal, Khirwadkar, Tomar, Das and Joshi 2000, Makwana 2004, Sharma 2005, Bharat 2005, Pradeshi 2005, and Rathod 2005, MSU, Suvanna 2004, SGU Upadhyay 1999, MJP Rohilkhand University, Bareilly, Sanjana 2001, MDU, and Pandian 2004, DU. There have been found rare studies on the pedagogic, techno-pedagogic analysis of the computer-based educational instructional programs. These studies reveal that there should be added focus on production variables, pedagogic principles, and spatial and temporal contiguity of various message forms. Patel 2001, MSU, Chaudhary 2005, MSU. Computer as a medium has been found to have the potency of addressing the heterogeneity in terms of variables, namely intelligence quotient, interest, motivation, language level, Jyod 1999, MSU. There are rare studies on effectiveness of CAM, that is computer assisted learning material, in various modes, namely text, graphics, text and graphics, text, graphics and music. It has been found that the composite modes may not always ensure higher level of language learning. Thus, 1998, MSU. Very few studies have been conducted on the relative effectiveness of CAI with peer interaction in mono, dyad, and triad, Pradeshi, 2005, MSU. Attempts have been made for designing, developing, and implementing computer-based learning resources management system, LRMS. The automated LRMS has been found definitely more effective than the manual LRMS, Barya 1995, DABB. A few studies have been conducted on the relative predictivity of various variables with respect to the criterion variables, namely educational proficiency, Mishra 1993, DABB, Goyal 2003, MSU. A study conducted on time-space personal management system revealed that the computer-based TSPM system was found relatively more acceptable and better functional than the manual TSPMS, Bishwal 1995, DABB. Though studies have been conducted on the automation of examination system, yet these studies find rare expression at the functional level. Teacher education institutions need to promote choice-based credit system and on-demand examination, Mahajan 1993, DABB, Joseph 1993, DABB, Shinde 1993, DABB, Goel 1997, MSU. A sizable number of teacher education institutions in India have initiated into ICT in education either as a core course or as an optional course. In spite of the impeding factors, namely limited staff, inadequate laboratories with maintenance problems, sizable classes, The courses have been found to realize their objectives reasonably. Goel, Das and Shilat, 2003, MSU. A sizable number of teacher education institutions have been found lacking facilities such as internet, MS Publisher, Acrobat Reader, Goel 2005, MSU. A few studies conducted on the use of internet in teacher education institutions revealed that the student teachers largely lack in info-savvy skills and techno-pedagogic skills. Joshi 1999, MSU, Dhodi 2005, MSU. Some of the teacher trainings make use of internet for surfing, email, research, core courses, and special areas. But the internet is rarely used for web designing, reflective dialogue, and outsourcing. Measures of internet safety are rarely employed. There is a need to develop net savvy skills in teacher-educator trainees, Goel 2006, MSU. Some studies have been conducted on bridging the gaps between teaching styles and learning styles. The studies are appreciable, but there is a need to conduct many more studies, Rathore 2005, MSU. Studies conducted on language instruction through PowerPoint presentation on realizing communicative and functional languages have been found to a great way in establishing the effectiveness of learning various languages, Yadav 2005 MSU, Rathore 2005 MSU. There have been rare studies on developing language learning strategies and learning autonomy through weblogs. Blogs not only provide teachers with an exciting new way to approach communicative language learning, these also give students a new reason to enjoy reading and writing. Nana Dhodi 2011 demonstrated very well how the info-savvy skills of asking, accessing, analyzing, applying, and assessing were developed in the pre-service teachers of India through surfing on cultural heritage of India and Buddhist heritage of India and the domains of their respective discipline methods. It is a joyful experience to travel through her doctoral thesis, experiencing various surfing skills, namely skimming, scanning, authenticating, hyperlinking, switching, skipping, culminating into educational immersion for seeking solutions. Educational technology and ICT in education have demonstrated their values, but technology in education is not yet fully integrated. Technology in education is still underutilized. Now, language learning. The communicative, interactive, constructive approach has been found more effective than structural approach, whereas structural approach has been found to be more effective than grammar translation approach. The media-supported approaches have been found to be more effective than traditional, conventional approach. Multilingual model of language instruction has been found to be more effective than monolingual model. Media language proficiency has been found to facilitate learning a great deal. Now we go on to the studies on teaching methods. Study on evaluation of mathematics textbooks of 5th, 6th and 7th standards revealed that there is absence of continuity in chapters and lack of activity-oriented exercises. Jayashri R. Pai, 1997, MSU. Study on development of science education in Nagaland concluded that more than half the total number of the science teachers, 57%, were of the opinion that objectives of science education were not clear to them and accordingly less achievement of objectives of science education. Pianu 2004, Kohima. The study on the science curriculum transaction in secondary schools of Baroda city revealed that teachers are not clear with values of science, P.S. Umashri, 1999, MSU. Student teachers are found to be more interested in using innovative methods of teaching the language than working teachers. English language teaching at school level is found to be suffering from lack of interest and attitude. Shamata Chaudhary, 2002, VMOU. Use of inductive thinking model to teach science at primary level proved fruitful in developing the reasoning ability of students. Livia 2002, VN, South Gujarat University. Now, educational evaluation. Various studies under the section educational evaluation focused on remedial programs, Archana Srivastava 2004, Vikram University, Ujjain. System of performance appraisal for teachers Muhammad Abbas Ali, 2003, University of Mumbai, Mumbai. Continuous and Comprehensive Evaluation, Pushpanjali Pani, 2004, Utkal University, Bhubaneswar. And Evaluation of Teachers by Students, Srirang Baburav Shirsagar, 2006, Pune University, Pune. Remedial programs developed to improve achievement have been found to be effective in bringing the results. Both B.Ed. students and B.Ed. teachers are of the opinion that students' evaluation of the teachers should be there if taken positively and constructively. N.S. Rathod, Bhavnagar University, 1993, conducted a study on application of item response theory to criterion reference testing. J.A. Ramanuj, Bhavnagar University, 1997, conducted a study on development and standardization of criterion referenced mastery test on surface tension, capillary action, and viscosity in the subject of science in Gujarati. Teacher education should provide substantive inputs on CRT, IRT, and NRT, that is criterion reference test, item response theory, and norm reference testing, strengthen evaluation. M. Singh, Agra University, 1994, conducted a study of the differential effect of anxiety on performance in progressive and terminal examinations. A large majority of the candidates while taking examination are rarely normal because of the faulty examination system, be it admission into the educational programs, periodical tests, or attend test. Fear of failure and hope of success keep disturbing the candidates. Could the testing be personalized? S. Meera Avinashalingam, Deemed University, 1995, has done an evaluation of the total internal assessment system in the Avinashalingam Deemed University. The CBCS and total internal evaluation is highly desirable. K. Charate, Barkatullah University, 1993, has done an investigation into the causes of low achievement among normal children and attempted to design an appropriate curriculum and instructional strategies to tackle these. K.S. Vishwanathan, University of Calicut, 1997, studied the effect of diagnostic error learning strategy on the achievement of slow learners of Standard 9 in mathematics. K. Bose, Jamia Millia Islamia, 1996, studied the effectiveness of computer programs as remedial strategies for overcoming certain learning disabilities. Neela Shilat and Anjali Mehta, MSU, 2003, have done an investigation into errors committed by students of Standard 8 in writing Gujarati. Number of attempts have been made on construction and standardization of tests in various areas. All these studies have definitely added to the knowledge base in the area of educational evaluation. Now we focus on environmental education. Video film on environmental pollution was found to be effective in eliciting students' positive responses. Indubala U. Singh, 1999, South Gujarat University, Surat. Teacher educators were found to be very positive towards environmental education. Anuradha, 2005, Punjab University, Chandigarh. The instructional programs on environmental studies facilitated the teacher in evolving teaching strategies for enhancing teacher-pupil interactions during the acquisition of process skills. N. Ram Kumar, 2004, MSU, Baroda. Father Rayappan Irudayam, S.J., MSU, 2006, conducted a study on development and implementation of a computer-based multimedia software package to enhance environmental awareness in the students of Standard 9. The environmental education needs to be institutionalized in teacher education very intensively. Now we go on to human rights education. A large majority of the teacher educators and teachers and learners are not aware of human rights. There is progressively some awakening in the field of teacher education. A curriculum has been designed on human rights education for the children below the age of 14 years, Swarn Prabha Sahu, 2002, Utkal University, Bhubaneswar. The programs designed, developed, and implemented on human rights and child rights have been found significantly effective. Mamta Sheth, 2007, MSU, Rucha Desai, 2007, MSU, respectively. Childhood is so tender a phase that it ought to be fully respected and skillfully nurtured to realize its full bloom. Every child is the extension of man and a promise to sustain mankind. United Nations has worked to free people from economic poverty, slavery and servitude, disease and discomfort, to lead healthy, happy, meaningful and full life. There are evident gains, but these gains are in doubt. Even now, some Icelanders are captured and gatekeepers appointed to issue visa. Too many people are living in fear. Under economic recession, highly competent people are in fear of losing their jobs. Respect for human rights demands not only awareness of human rights, but also favorable attitude towards human rights. Human rights education ought to be an integral area of education. Now, life skills and value education. Various studies in the section Life Skills and Value Education are focusing on aesthetic sensitivity, critical thinking, and values towards society, profession, and family. Strategies developed for teaching critical thinking revealed that thinking approach can facilitate the students to understand and relate to the concepts through self-analysis, evaluation, and judgment. Meghani, 1999, MSU. Some studies conducted on identification of deviant thinking patterns and clinical sessions thereof reveal that thinking patterns can change through counseling in a relatively short period of time. Cognitive counseling technique is useful in acquisition of desirable thinking. Goel and Joseph, 1994, DABB. Induction program for teachers' classroom communication was found to be effective in improving interpersonal relationship patterns of communication through transactional analysis training. Nairondia, Samuel Maragia, 2000, MSU. Gender and religion have been found to influence value formation. Model curriculum developed for crisis management was found to be helpful in achieving results in a desired way and recommended for consideration of the NCERT, CABE and SCERT. Sainath Pandurang Shenoy, 2005, Mumbai University. Sheetal Ahluwalia implemented a life skills program on the pre-service teachers during 2008-09 at the MS University of Baroda, Vadodara and Gujarat, India. Post-intervention scenario on life skills of the student teachers revealed that there was a remarkable gain in their self-awareness skill, effective communication skill, interpersonal relationship skill, coping with emotion skills, decision-making skill, and problem-solving skill. There was moderate gain in their coping with stress skill, empathy skill, critical thinking skill, and creative thinking skill. Neither have we fully known our strengths nor our weaknesses. Creative and critical thinking skills, both in one, is a rare combination. Life skills education and value education ought to be well integrated in education. Now, technical and vocational education. Two studies were reviewed under the section technical and vocational education. Both are comparing the educational status in different locations. Regarding comparative study of technical education of India and Germany, the findings revealed that the aims and objectives of technical education in India and Germany are same, except emphasis on profession and professional training in objectives of technical education in Germany. The vocational schools and University of Applied Sciences are autonomous. Vocational schools in Germany adopt statewide common curricula, unlike in India, which is common nationwide. Ajit Ram Rao, Thatte, 1999, BMU. Another comparative study on vocational education interests of Urdu and Marathi medium students revealed that no significant difference was found between the mean scores on the vocational interest of the Urdu and Marathi medium students. The jobs related to household and social and scientific fields were preferred by most of the girls in the sample. Rahat Sultana, 2001, Bamu, Aurangabad. Thank you.